In this tutorial, we will create this 3D object in AutoCAD 2022. I request you to watch this complete tutorial to understand 3D modeling concept in AutoCAD 2022 perfectly. If you want to learn AutoCAD 3D from basic to advanced level, then link to complete playlist is given in description below. If you are interested in more such type of videos, then please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. Let's start with this object. At first, you will have to start new drawing. For that, click here on this arrow. And you can select this acadiso.twt template because our drawing is in millimeter. And if this template is not available here, then you will have to click here on browse templates. And from here you can select this ACAD ISO. Click on open. Then to switch to 3D modeling, click here on this gear icon and select this 3D modeling. Then it will show these 3D commands. Right now only X and Y axis are visible. To view Z axis, click here on unsaved view and click on SE isometric. So here now Z axis is visible. Then to shift this UCS icon on left side, type UCS icon, press enter and click on no origin. So it will shift that UCS icon on the left side. Now in this object, at first we will create this half portion and we will mirror it. So to create this base object, at first we will have to create this sketch. As this sketch is vertical, therefore we will have to change UCS. Right now our XY axis is horizontal. We want it to be aligned with this face. So to work on this face, you will have to use right UCS. And if you want to work on this face, you will have to use front UCS. And to work on this horizontal face, you will have to use top UCS. So for this face, we will use right UCS. So to change UCS, click here on world and click here on right. So here you will see that plane has been changed and our XY axis is vertical and Z is horizontal. Now we will start this sketch from this point. At first we will create this line of 27 size, then this line of half of this 46, that is 23. Then vertical line of 25 and again this vertical line of 25, that is 50 minus this 25, that means this will be 25. And we will create this half line of 12.5 because we are going to create half portion. Click here on line. Then you can start object from any point. Suppose I will start it from 0, 0. So type here 0, 0, enter. Then make ortho on. Take your cursor on this side. Specify length of 27, enter. Then zoom there. Again take your cursor on this side. Then 23, half of 46, enter. Then take your cursor on this side. 25, enter, zoom minus, then take your cursor on this side, 12.5, enter, then click here on this endpoint. You can also make ortho mode off so that it will be visible perfectly. Click here on this endpoint and press enter to stop line command. So here this shape is ready. Then next is this line of 25 height, that is 50 minus this 25, and this line of 20 height. Then we will create this line of 30 length, that is half of this 60. You can press enter to repeat last command. Click here on this endpoint. Make ortho on. Take your cursor on this side, 25, enter. Then take your cursor on this side, 30, enter, enter, again enter to repeat line command. Click here on this endpoint, take your cursor on this side, 20, enter, and click here on this endpoint, press enter. So this sketch is perfectly ready. Then next is to convert this shape into 3D. Thickness of this part is 50. To convert this object into 3D, click here on press pull. Take your cursor inside this shape. Once it becomes blue, click there. Take your cursor on this side, 50, enter, and press escape to stop press pull command. Then to watch this object in 3D look, click here on 2D wireframe and click on shaded with edges. Then I don't want to see these grid lines, click here on display drawing grid. So it will turn it off. So here this portion is perfectly ready. Then next is to create this cut. Now here this length is 5. Then this length is 20 and from either side it is 15. That means this object is at the center of this horizontal line. So in this, at first we will create this rectangle of 5 by 20 size. Then we will press pull it by 25 depth. Click here on rectangle. Then click in empty space, take your cursor away. Now here we are on right plane, but now we have to work on top plane. So press escape and click here and click on top. Now here XY axis are horizontal, that is parallel to this face. Click here on rectangle, click in empty space, take your cursor away, then specify here 20, press tab. Then specify 5, press enter. Then we will move this rectangle and place it here. For that, click here on move, select this object, press enter. Then base point will be this midpoint, click on it and click on this midpoint. So here it has been placed perfectly. Then to cut it, again click on press pull. Click inside this shape, take your cursor below, specify depth of 25, enter, press escape, then orbit it, press shift, press middle mouse button and drag the mouse. So here this cut has been created perfectly. Then we will have to cut this complete portion. For that, click here on press pull, then take your cursor to this vertical rectangle. Click there, take it outside, ensure that you are coming out of this object, click, press escape, then orbit it. So here this cut has been created perfectly. Then remove these unwanted lines, for that type E, enter, and select these lines, enter. Then we want same shape on the opposite side. So for that we will mirror it. Click here on 3D mirror, select this object, enter. Then we will have to specify 3 points of the plane around which we want to mirror. So we will have to mirror around this plane. So select 3 points of this plane. I will select this end point as a first point, this end point as a second point, and this end point as a third. Then no. So here this mirror is created. Now these two objects are separate. We want them to be connected. For that, click here on solid union. Then select this object and this object and press enter. Okay, it was not selected perfectly. Again, I will select here on solid union. Once it becomes blue, click on it and this one, press enter. So here this object has been connected perfectly and I don't want this line. Here I am not able to select this line. So what I will do for easy selection, click here and select this 2D wireframe. In 2D wireframe, it is very easy to select unwanted objects. Then press delete. Again click here, click on shaded with edges and click here on SE isometric. So here this object is perfectly ready. Then next is to create this cylinder of 10 and 20 radius and 25 height. And this internal cylinder is actually a through hole. So zoom there. Click here on circle, center radius. Then take your cursor to this midpoint. Then this midpoint. Now because of dynamic UCS, actually we are not able to select it perfectly. So what we will do? We will turn off that dynamic UCS. But here dynamic UCS is not visible. To make it visible, click here on these three lines, customization, and here is dynamic UCS. Click on it, click outside. So here dynamic UCS is shown. Just click on it, so it will get turned off. As it is turned off, so it will not select that plane automatically and it will be easy to work. Then take your cursor to this midpoint. And one more thing, we will have to turn this object snap tracking on and also ensure that this midpoint is selected because we are going to track midpoint object snap. Again, take your cursor to this midpoint and this midpoint and take it in the center. So here it is tracking perfectly. Click there, take it away. Then radius is 10, enter. Again press enter to repeat last command. Take your cursor over circle. Now here it is showing center object snap. Click there, take it away. Then 20, enter. Then we want this hole through. For that click here on principle. Then click inside this circle. Take it below and click and orbit it. So here this through hole is created. Then click inside these two circles, take it on this side, 25, enter, press escape. Then to change color, double click here, again click here and from here you can choose your desired color, press escape, click here on AC isometric. So here this object is perfectly ready. So thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. We will again meet in next tutorial.